Hello, welcome to this session, Data Structure Gate Questions. At the end of this session, the student will be able to solve data structure problems. Initially, we'll put one question, try to answer it. To implement Dijkstra shortest path algorithm on unweighted graph, so that it run in the linear time, what data structure will be used? Here four data structures are given: queue, stack, heap and B-tree. Now this is a shortest path algorithm. When we want to reach from A to C, then this will be shortest path A to B, B to C, as it is an unweighted graph. So smallest node will be considered, and A to D and D to C, that will be longest path. Now here, as we have seen, that is the shortest path is unweighted graph. The smallest number of edges must be traversed in order to reach the destination in the graph. So Q, as it is having first in, first out, we can keep smallest edges and we can use that deleting smallest edges. So if we use Q, we can get the shortest path in linear time. Next, question number 2. Suppose a circular queue of capacity n minus 1 element is implemented with an array of n element, means the queue is of n capacity and we can keep from 0 to n minus 1. Assume that insertion and deletion operations are carried out using rear and front as array index variable respectively, where initially rear is equal to front is equal to 0. The condition to detect queue full and queue empty are. Now here some four conditions are given where we have to find out which is correct answer for full queue and empty queue. Now we'll see the circular queue. This is a circular queue, this is a linear queue where we are having rear and front. Here we are having rear and front, and once we are full, again we are reaching to the zeroth position. After finishing the n position, we are reaching again to the zeroth position. But in the linear queue, we have to go from 0 to the last, and we can't come to the 0 though it is a empty. Now we'll see this head. It is always point to the location from where next deletion takes place from the queue. So head or front is the pointer where the location from where next deletion will be take place, and rear or tell is pointing to that location where we can insert a new number. Now in the circular queue, as I said, we can use this wrap around features in the circular queue. When the tell or head is at the index, last index n minus 1, next operation will be bring to them to the index 0, and we will reserve one empty spot in order to detect the overflow and underflow conditions. Then the element is in the queue resides in the location from like this q head plus 1 up to the tell, and when tell plus 1, again it will be going to the head. So this is the wrap around condition. Now here we can see that when nothing is there, when it is empty, so at that position front is equal to rear. So this is the empty condition. So we can write empty condition is equal to front is equal to rear. Now we will start to include some values insert 14, the rear will be now next, it is showing which is the next position where we can insert the value. So here your rear is there, I am inserting here 22, again your rear will be next, 13 is included, like this we are incrementing the rear. And when I am deleting, in this case now front 14 will be deleted, now front will come to the next value which can be deleted from the queue. So 22 is the next value, so front is showing the, when I am deleting 22, it will come to the 13. So like this you can increase the front and rear as per the operations. Now in this case when I am inserting all the value, that time my rear is reaching to the nearly end condition and front is to the value, now it is from 0, 1, 2. Now front is at the second condition. And I want to insert one more value, so I can wrap around condition. So here the rear has come to the 0th position, now it can be come to the next position, it is showing, that is the first position. Now here it is a full condition. Now if we can see, that is the full condition. So if I am incrementing rear by 1, I am reaching to the front. When I am doing rear plus 1 mod n, n is the capacity. So this is the full condition. And empty condition, as we have seen at the start, when it is a empty, rear is equal to front. So A is a correct answer. A priority queue is used to implement a stack S that stores character push C is implemented as insert. In the push we are pushing C, and in the insert we are having that queue. C is the character we are pushing, and K is the appropriate integer key chosen by the implementation. Now pop is implemented as delete mean, means minimum value has to be deleted from the queue. For a sequence of operation, the key should be chosen and which key should be appropriate for this. Now here we are implementing a priority queue first, that we are using stack, and that priority queue is on the base of minimum should be deleted first. So in this condition, which will be the appropriate option? Non-increasing order, non-decreasing order, strictly increasing order and strictly decreasing order. Now as here we have seen that implementing a stack using priority queue, here it will be stack implementation is always last in first out order. So in stack, last element is pushed should be popped out first. In the priority queue, minimum element is given the highest priority. So it should come out first, minimum value. Now whenever we call delete minimum, it will be pop the element with the minimum value. Then the minimum element should be inserted last, or inserted should be in the decreasing order, means in the stack it should be insert into the decreasing order, and it should be strictly decreasing order. Why? Non-increasing order, that will also work, but that will be one disadvantage, that for two elements when they are equal value, the priority queue will pick any one of the randomly. So which will not be case in the stack. So we have to implement with the strictly decreasing order. So as we have seen, this question is priority queue, and we have to implement using the stack, and we have to push that in strictly decreasing order, so that when we are deleting that value, the minimum value should be come out first, as it is having the highest priority. Thank you.